गुड मॉर्निंग टू स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ बी हाइव, रीच फॉर द टॉप, अबाउट संतोष यादव. सो हियर इन दिस चैप्टर, बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द चैप्टर, वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन. टीम फॉर बाय एंड मेक अ लिस्ट ऑफ थ्री टू फाइव पर्संस यू आइडियलाइज और एडमायर वेरी मच फॉर देयर अचीवमेंट्स. योर आइडल्स मे बी फ्रॉम एनी स्फीयर ऑफ लाइफ, स्पोर्ट्स, मेडिसिन, मीडिया और आर्ट एंड कल्चर. सो यू थिंक अबाउट द पर्सन हु यू रिस्पेक्ट और ही कैन बी और दे कैन बी फ्रॉम एनी स्फीयर ऑफ लाइफ ऑफ एनी फील्ड ऑफ लाइफ. दे कैन बी फ्रॉम स्पोर्ट, मेडिसिन, मीडिया और कल्चर. सो हियर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट संतोष यादव. Here, the only woman in the world who has made Mount Everest twice was born in a society where the birth of a son was regarded as a blessing, and daughter, though not considered as a curse, was not generally welcome. So here, the only woman in the world who has made means that woman who was Santosh Yadav, who has scaled Mount Everest twice. And was born in society where the birth of a son was regarded as a blessing. And that Santosh Yadav, that was a girl. She was born in society where the son was regarded as a blessing, but daughter not as a curse. But they didn't accept or they did not desire for the daughter. Here, when her mother was accepting Santosh, a traveling holy man, giving her his blessings, assumed that she wanted a son. Here, when her mother was accepting Santosh, a traveling holy man, means one traveling holy man came one day in Santosh Yadav's house, home, giving her his blessings, assumed that she wanted a son. Means he assumed when that holy man visited there in the house, in home of Santosh Yadav, he assumed that they want a son. But to everyone's surprise, the unborn child's grandmother, who was standing close by, means when that holy man came in Santosh Yadav's home, he was standing, means her grandmother, Santosh Yadav's grandmother, was standing just near that holy man, and standing close by told him that they did not want a son. Okay, that grandmother of Santosh Yadav told that holy man they didn't want a son. The holy man was also surprised when he listened that they don't want a son, they want a daughter, that he was surprised. Nevertheless, he gave the requested blessings. Okay, when they desired, means her grandmother desired for a daughter, they don't want a son, then he surprised to that holy man. And as destiny would have it, the blessings seemed to her. Okay, Santosh Yadav was born the sixth child in a family with five sons. Santosh Yadav was having five brothers, and in five brothers, she was only child. As a girl, a sister. That five brothers means in five brothers she was only a sister. She was born in a small village of Joniawas of Rewari district in Haryana. And she was born in Joniawas of Rewari district in Haryana. She belonged to Haryana from the Rewari district in Joniawas. And the girl was given the name Santosh. Okay? Which means contentment, means satisfaction. And when she was born, Santosh Yadav was born, she was named Santosh, and that means contentment or satisfaction. But Santosh was not always content with her place in her traditional way of life. She was not satisfied. She was not content or she was not satisfied. She was always content with her place in her traditional way of life. And she began living life on her own terms from start. Means she wanted to live life in her own condition. Okay? By her own condition, in her own condition, and from start where other girls wore traditional Indian dresses and those preferred shorts. Means other girls of that village wanted, they used to wear the traditional Indian dresses, but Santosh preferred to wear shorts. Looking back, she says, now from the very beginning I was quite determined, and that if I choose a correct and rational path, the others around me had to change, not me. Means where other girls wore traditional Indian dresses, Santosh preferred shorts. And looking back, means she looked back, she says, now from the very beginning I was quite determined. I was completely determined. Means I decided that if I chose a correct and rational path, means a logical or correct path, hai na, the others around me had to change, not me. Means if I will change myself, the other girls of this society will change, hai na, themselves. See, think as Santosh's parents were affluent landowners who could afford to send their children to the best schools, even to the country's capital. Okay, Santosh's parents were landowners. They were affluent landowners, very rich people. They were parents. They were, and they could afford to send their children. Enough. They were able to send their children to the best school, even the country's capital. But what happened next? New Delhi, which was quite close by. Okay, but in line with the prevailing custom in the family, means in line with the, means following or according with, means according to the prevailing custom, means according to popular custom of her family, her society, and Santosh had to make do with the local village school. Means she wanted to study in the local village school. Means Santosh had to make, means in line, means according to that society, all the girls would study there in the local village school. But actually they, means her parents were able to send their child in Delhi also, in good school also. So she decided, Santosh had to make do with the local village school according to her prevailing custom of her family. But she decided to fight the system in her own quiet way then, quiet way, when the right moment arrived. And but she decided to fight with the system, that prevailing system of her society or of her family. She decided to fight with that, and in her own quiet way, means in her own way, in her quiet way, in her peaceful way, she decided to fight with that custom when the right moment arrived. And the right moment came when she turned 16. And when she turned 16, that right moment arrived. For that she was waiting. And at 16, most of the girls in her village used to get married. And at 16, at the age of 16, most of the girls of that village, of her village, used to get married. And Santosh was also under pressure from her parents to do the same. And she was also under pressure, means she was also pressurized by her parents to get married in, when she was 16 years old. A marriage as early as that was the last thing on her mind. And she thought that marriage will be the last thing of my life. She threatened her parents, you know, that she would never marry if she didn't get a proper education. And she thought about her marriage and her education, and she threatened her parents that if I will not get the proper education, I will not marry. When her parents refused to pay her education, and before that she left home and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. And as they wanted, means her parents wanted to marry her, you know, she left her home and got herself enrolled. Means she had got admission, you know, in a school in New Delhi. When her parents refused to pay for her education, she politely informed them, you know, of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay her school fees. Then she left and she informed that I want some money to pay my school fees. Okay, she politely informed. And she wanted, but say there her parents refused to pay the fees of refused to pay the education fees. And then when they refused, her parents refused, she informed politely that to earn money by working part-time job to pay her school fees. Her parents then agreed to pay for her education. And then she politely informed afterward that her parents agreed to pay her school fees. Wishing always to study a bit more, and with her father slowly getting used to her urge for more education. Means by her urge, means her request, her father agreed to provide the more education. Santosh passed the high school examination and went to Jaipur. She joined Maharani College and got a room in Kasturba Hostel. And after that, after her education, after Santosh passed the high school, means after high school, you know, examination, she went to Jaipur. She joined Maharani College and got a room in Kasturba Hostel. Then she got enrolled in Maharani College. After that, she got a room in Kasturba Hostel. Santosh remembers Kasturba Hostel faced the Kasturba Hostel faced the Aravali Hills. I used to watch villagers from my room going up the hills and suddenly vanishing after a while. And when she got a room in Kasturba Hostel, that the gate of the Kasturba Hostel faced to Aravali Hills. And she would watch the villagers, and she used to watch the villagers up in coming and going from there, going up the hills and suddenly vanishing. Means she looked that some villagers, they were coming and going. Means they were going there and suddenly they vanished from there, from the Aravali Hills for a while. One day I decided to check it out myself, and when she saw that the people, the villagers, they are coming and going, and suddenly they disappeared. And she decided to check it out. Means to find out about the truth, and found nobody except a few mountaineers. And she found that those villagers were nobody except mountaineers. They were mountaineers, and they were going and coming, and suddenly they disappeared. I asked if I could join them, and when she found that they are the mountaineers, she asked them to join them. To my pleasant surprise, they answered in affirmative and motivated me to take to climb. And when she asked to join them, they answered in an affirmative, means in a positive way, they answered, and they motivated her, Santosh Yadav, for climbing or to take climb.